Strange Mariana Trench from Nature Diaries. The oceans are full of mysteries and strange life forms, and nowhere in the wet parts of the world are more mysterious than the Mariana Trench. A trench is part of a system which forms the boundary between two tectonic plates. While thousands of people have summited Mount Everest, the highest point on Earth, less than a handful have managed to explore our planet's deepest ocean point, a location known as the Challenger Deep in the Pacific Ocean's Mariana Trench. This vast ocean pit in the western Pacific reveals new secrets whenever a brave explorer ventures in its lethal depths, and continues to amaze even the most jaded ocean researcher. The Mariana Trench is located in the Pacific Ocean, just east of the 14 Mariana Islands near Japan. Now, as you know, it is the deepest part in the Earth's oceans, and the deepest location of the Earth humans could ever reach. It was created by ocean-to-ocean subduction and is about 180 million years old. Let's take a look at some of its strangest aspects and most enduring mysteries. In 1875, the trench was discovered, in the seabed of the western Pacific Ocean, near the Mariana Islands, by the HMS Challenger, using then-invented sounding equipments, during a global circumnavigation. It is about 2,550 kilometers or 1,580 miles long, and has an average width of only 69 kilometers or 43 miles. Its maximum known depth is 10,994 meters or 36,070 feet, at a small slot-shaped valley in its floor at its southern end, known as the Challenger Deep. Some estimates say it could be as deep as 11,034 meters or 36,201 feet, but this is unconfirmed. Initially, the Mariana Trench was found by explorers using ropes and lead weights, which they lowered to the seabed. Later, more accurate readings were taken using sonar systems. In 1951, the trench was sounded again by HMS Challenger 2. But the trench is still largely unknown for the researchers. At the bottom of the trench, the water above exerts a pressure of 1,086 bars or 15,750 psi, which is over 1,000 times the standard atmospheric pressure at sea level and is the equivalent of having 50 jumbo jets piled on top of you. The pressure at the deepest part of the Mariana Trench is over 8 tons per square inch. The temperature at the bottom is 1 to 4 degrees Celsius and the trench is cloaked in perpetual darkness. These kind of hostile conditions make impossible for the explorers to carry on their task in the trench. In 1875, the trench was discovered by the HMS Challenger using then-invented sounding equipments during a global circumnavigation. In 1951, the trench was sounded again by HMS Challenger 2 and observed the deepest point. Challenger Deep was named after the two vessels who discovered it. In 1960, a deep boat named Bathyscaphe Trieste reached the bottom of Challenger Deep. It was the first vessel to do so. In 1995, the Japanese unmanned submarine Keiko gathered samples and useful data from the trench. In 2009, the United States sent a hybrid remotely operated vehicle, Nereus, to the floor of Challenger Deep. The vehicle remained on the seabed for nearly 10 hours. In 2012, James Cameron manned the deep-sea Challenger and reached the seabed but was unable to capture any photos due to a hydraulic fluid leak. The Mariana Trench was formed through a process called subduction. Earth's crust is made up of comparably thin plates that float on the molten rock of the planet's mantle. While floating on the mantle, The edges of these plates slowly bump into each other and sometimes even collide head-on. When two plates crash into each other, an oceanic plate plunges downward into the mantle, while the other plate rides up over the top. This movement creates a trench where the descending oceanic plate drags down the edge of the overriding plate. The Mariana Trench is located at a convergent plate boundary. Here, two converging plates of oceanic lithosphere collide with one another. At this collision point, one of the plates descends into the mantle. At the line of contact between these two plates, the downward flexure forms a deep trough known as the Mariana Trench. Ocean trenches form some of the deepest locations in Earth's oceans. Part of the reasons that the Challenger Deep is largely unexplored is due to hydrostatic pressure. When you enter any body of water and begin diving down from the surface, the deeper you dive, the more water covers you. The more gallons of water between you and the surface, the greater is the pressure on your body. When you dive into a swimming pool and go all the way to the bottom of the deep end, you can often feel the hydrostatic pressure against your eardrums, a feeling of having them squeezed or pushed in. Magnify that feeling by thousands and you can imagine how incredible the pressure would be in the Challenger Deep with almost 7 miles of water overhead. As challenging as it is to explore the Mariana Trench and the Challenger Deep in particular, few intrepid explorers have succeeded in this antagonistic task. The Mariana Trench occurs along a plate boundary between the Philippine Plate and the Pacific Plate. The Pacific Plate is on the eastern and southern side of this boundary, and the Philippine Plate is on the western and northern side of this boundary. Both of these plates are moving in a northwesterly direction, but the Pacific Plate is moving faster than the Philippine Plate. The motion of these plates produces a convergent plate boundary because the greater speed of the Pacific Plate is causing it to collide into the Philippine Plate. This collision produces a subduction zone at the Mariana Trench as the Pacific Plate descends into the mantle and under the Philippine Plate. The plates are usually stuck with pressure accumulating, but with sudden slips as the plates move a few millimeters to a few meters at a time. When the plates slip, vibrations are produced, and those vibrations travel through Earth's crust as earthquake waves. Recurrent earthquakes occur along this plate boundary because the Pacific Plate's descent into the mantle is not smooth and uniform and often generate tsunamis in this area. One of the strangest things that have emanated from the Mariana Trench is the mysterious biometallic sound that sometimes emanates from the trench is heard. Marine researchers have dubbed this almost mechanical, twangy noise named as Western Pacific Bio-Twang, and it first turned up in 2014 when scientists recorded ocean sounds near the Mariana Trench with diving robots called passive acoustic ocean gliders. The complex, 3.5-second sound turned up several times during the research period, and while it seemed mysterious, the scientists eventually decided that the most likely culprit is a mink whale, a peculiar small whale that can sound like a Star Wars sound effect. However, the mink whales themselves remain largely a mystery to science, and researchers still have no idea what the call is about, and why it has been recorded year-round. Incidentally, this isn't the first time the elusive mink whales have puzzled scientists. For 50 years, researchers were puzzled by a strange, duck-like underwater sound that seemed too repetitive and rhythmical to be anything but man-made, and far too loud to be a fish. We didn't figure out that this bio-duck sound was of mink whales until 2014. Weird whale noises are one thing, but when scientists managed to capture audio from the deepest ocean pit on the planet in 2016, things got all sorts of creepy. You would expect that the Challenger Deep would be a serenely quiet place at 7 miles beneath the surface, but recordings show that the area is actually chock full of sounds that seem like something out of a horror movie. Yes, the deep is full of screeches, moans and rumbles, and while the occasional sound can be traced back to a whale or an earthquake, a whole bunch of them remain a mystery. Perhaps the strangest thing about the recordings is the fact that you can often hear the surface sounds shockingly clearly, and boat propellers and typhoons are clearly audible on some of the tapes. When the creatures of the deep inevitably rise against us surface dwellers, there's a fair chance it will be because they're just coming to complain about their noisy upstairs neighbors. The Trench is technically a US territory, but since a giant, super deep ocean hole that contains all sorts of strange ecosystems is obviously fairly vulnerable to human tampering, President of USA declared it a Marine National Monument in 2009. This means that the majority of the Mariana Trench, along with a whole bunch of surrounding seafloor and several underwater volcanoes, are a protected marine reserve. The Mariana Trench is often used as a north-south passage by submarines as it is part of a long system of trenches that circle the Pacific Ocean, connected with the Japan and Kuril trenches. It's almost like our planet custom designed the Mariana Trench to be a mystery wrapped in an enigma, and made it as difficult as possible for a fragile human being to observe. It's a place of total darkness, cold, and crushing pressures, populated by alien-looking creatures and constantly bombarded by constant noise from both man-made and natural sources. All in all, there are belief systems out there that have less scary hells. We have tried to put the strange aspects regarding the Mariana Trench and believe that you are the best judge of the conclusion. In the next topic, we will discuss the vicinity and environmental concerns of Mariana Trench. Thank you and see you in the next video.